Майдану не повинен піти додому.
Бачу колір сонця, чую голос серця, я не заспокоюсь, і якщо прийдеться, буду захищати я свою країну, нас не подолати.
Багато, і нас не подолати.
Цей час вони уже не смотрять нам в глаза. Ми стали сильней.
Нам не бить стороне.
Замкнем ряди. Нам нужно миру показать. Ми в нашей стране.
Ми вас любимо, і ми віримо в те, що ви
будете. Любимой, єдиной.
Рита Ющенка! Ющенка!
Ніде мені ділимой, святою.
Я вас прошу, запам'ятайте одну годину. Дві години ночі.
Бачу колір сонця, чую голос серця, я не заспокоюсь, і якщо прийдеться, буду захищати.
Судове засідання оголошується закритим.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome here in Davos a true hero, President Viktor Yushchenko. President Kwasniewski, who played such an essential role in the negotiations and the positive outcome. Mr. President, your victory in such remarkable election represents a triumph for freedom, democracy, and the rule of law. It also signals Ukraine's desire to move towards a free and open market economy, more deeply integrated into the global economic and into the European system. Mr. President, the floor is yours.
Шановна президія,
dear panel,
шановні дорогі,
dear
друзі,
esteemed гості, friends, guests, colleagues in this room.
150 років назад,
150 years ago, a Ukrainian prophet, Тарас Шевченко,
сказав такі слова.
Said these words:
"Борітеся,
struggle, and you shall win.
Вам Бог допомагає.
The God helps you.
З вами правда.
The truth is with you. The strength is with you, and the holy will is with you. We were struggling, and we have won. And probably this is the most important thing of all the events that happened in recent months in Ukraine. You have just watched unique, and for many, unexpected moments. Millions of Ukrainians on the Maidan, the square in Kiev, were defending their rights, dignity, and justice. They manifested courage, patience, tolerance, and compassion. What's interesting, the people went out into streets not to demand their daily bread. They were united by the quest for freedom. For freedom, they defied cold and fear and shared bread and warmth with those who came to stand by. Armed only with belief in their right cause, they defeated tyranny and violence in a peaceful and beautiful manner. The entire world applauded them. A modern Ukrainian political nation emerged in front of the world, and this victory belongs not only to my people. Ukrainians showed that European values unite them on the Orange Maidan in Kiev, just the way they did so on the Velvet Square of Václav in Prague. If we believe that the history of human race is the history of freedom, then Ukraine is its herald in the third millennium. Ukraine has manifested that it belongs to the civilization of European nations. We are no longer at the crossroads nor at its margins. We are tread along the straight freeway. The European choice of Ukraine has taken root in the hearts and minds of the people. Today, I have the honor to address you on behalf of a free Ukraine. I was elected president by the will of its people, who favor democracy and prosperity, and I only have one goal: to execute their will. I represent one of the largest states in Europe that accommodates its geographic center. Ukrainians are one of the most educated nations in the world. We lack nothing to stand by the leaders of the contemporary globalized world. My country has long been a wise, strong, though sleeping elephant. It is awaking today. Democracy opens the way to implementing its potential. And I'm sure that in Ukraine today, we are observing the formation of the most advanced European market. Back in 2000, my government led Ukraine to the rise in economy. We laid then the basis for the GDP growth, which last year reached 12.4%. We have all reasons to be optimistic about the future forecast. However, many opportunities for the economic buildup have been wasted in previous years. The economy stayed disproportional and the social standards looked very low. They tried to impose the oligarchic type of economy, causing the expansion of its shadow side and permeating corruption. And investors responded accordingly. The amount of foreign investments is much lower than we observe with our neighbors. The per capita FDI in Ukraine is as little as $165, while in Russia the same index is 280, in Poland 2100, and the Czech Republic 4200. The time of wasted opportunities is over now. We begin the time of utilized opportunities together with you. Our goal is to transform the Ukrainian economy into a social market system and to ensure its sustainable growth. This is our first strategic goal. In order to achieve this goal, in the nearest future, we will undertake a number of steps, which include, first, the shadow economy shall be brought back onto the legal track. 55% of the economy remain in shadow. Taxes will be reduced, but everybody will pay them. In the nearest future, the privileges and benefits for the chosen few will be abolished. The tax system will become transparent and sustainable. The second step is the restoration of macroeconomic stability. The budget will be well balanced. Its stabilizing function will be enhanced through adjustments in an introduction of stringent budget restrictions and adoption of clearer principles of government loans. Thirdly, fight against corruptions. My government will not be stealing, nor will local governments. Business will be separated from politics. We will remove unnecessary impediments and excessive regulation, which breeds corruption. Administrative reform will promote transparency of the government at all levels. The fourth step. Consolidation and institution of fair justice. We shall establish independence of the judiciary and complete the judicial reform in Ukraine. The court will become an effective legal mechanism for disputes resolution. Attraction of investments is the fifth step. We are interested in seeing the advent of modern technologies and new business culture. We shall promote investments through legal and economic mechanisms. Privatization will be transparent, and competition among investors for appealing facilities will be fair. A couple of days ago, by the way, by decision of the court, assets of Krivorizhstal, the facility that had very notorious privatization record, the assets were seized. In addressing our goal, we are prepared to work with our partners across the globe. Our next strategy, Ukraine wants to be more intensively integrated in the global economy. We shall seek prompt granting of market-based economy status and will accelerate our accession to WTO. And this is the assignment for 2005. Ukraine stands for strengthening partnership for mutual benefits with all its neighbors in the East and in the West. We are prepared to comprehensively develop partnership with the Russian Federation, pursuing our economic interests, advocating peace and stability across Europe. I'm sure that this approach has been appreciated and welcomed during my visit to Moscow. The Orange Revolution paved the way to a new quality of our partnership with the United Europe. Our third strategic goal is Ukraine in the European Union. The history, economic prospects, interests of the people clearly show that the Ukrainian way to the future is the way which is tackled by the United Europe. The new Ukraine hopes to count on the support of European institutions and highly appreciates the message sent on the 13th of January by the European Parliament. I do believe that its appeal to give Ukraine a clear European prospect will be supported and taken on board by everybody. We welcome the European Union's intention to develop a new strategy for relations with Ukraine. We would like its purpose to be to open the EU door to our nation. The application for EU membership is intended to be filed in the near future. I would like to stress that Ukraine can make an important contribution in the build-up of a new united Europe. Let me cite just a couple of possibilities. Possibility one. We propose to intensify our cooperation in enhancing security and stability, especially in the regions of our common neighborhood. Number two, Ukraine is prepared to participate even more actively in implementing the objectives of the European security and defense policy. Our contribution in the peacemaking process in the Balkans has already received high appreciation. Ukraine is prepared to make its contribution to secure stable energy supply to Europe and to offer significant transit potential for its development. At this stage, we can launch the high-level dialogue with all on all energy issues right away. We shall welcome engagement of partners from the EU member states to set up a consortium for managing gas transportation facilities in Ukraine. No doubt my country will remain a trustworthy partner of the EU in our joint efforts to fight international terrorism and organized crime. I'm convinced that we have great opportunities to fulfill the formula: prosperous Ukraine in successful united Europe. We are ready to corroborate our aspirations by systemic, everyday work. I want every decision of the new government to be a step forward towards implementation of our goal. Introduction of European standards in society, economy, and politics shall become alpha and omega of the new government activity. I have a team capable of fulfilling my plan. We have developed a national strategy for European integration aimed at a swiftest possible attainment of the criteria for the EU membership. The strategy takes into account experience gained by our neighbors. It stipulates specific means of fulfilling the Copenhagen political and economic criteria, harmonizing the legal system, reforming the judiciary and law enforcement bodies, conducting a balanced foreign policy, and making necessary adjustments into the work of governmental structures. The new government will act within this strategy. Its implementation will be the criterion for evaluating the activity of all ministries. For better coordination within the government, I introduce as its member the post of a Vice Prime Minister responsible for European integration. I expect tangible results of this work in the near future. Dear friends, Ukraine is on the point of implementing its ambitious goals. But I'm convinced that these goals for my country, for my nation, are quite realistic. Due to the will of people that have set the country free from the burden of the past, the goals have been made realistic by the will of Ukrainians as a free European nation. You watched reports and stories from the Kiev Maidan, where Ukrainian flags were waved along with the flags of all European countries, ranging from Portugal to Poland. This is a look into the future. Ukraine is opening European history in the third millennium. I extend to you my greetings on behalf of New Ukraine, and I invite you to come to Ukraine. For us, it's of utmost importance in this historical point in time, not only for my nation, but for the whole of Europe, for you to be next to us. And I'm addressing you as a president. Please help Ukraine. And quite shortly, you'll see a European, beautiful nation.
Спасибо вам. Thank you.
I thank you very much.